In this video, we'll discuss about the types of plastics and how to use this plastic and what are the disadvantages of the usage of plastics, how to minimize the usage of plastics. That all points we'll discuss in this video. Mainly, this plastic is also contains polymers. So polymers means many monomers join and we get a long chain, that we'll call it as polymer. And these plastics are made from the polyester fiber. Why? Because the polyester fiber, while preparing, the fiber was melted and spun. So due to this, it changes into the required shapes and sizes. So due to that property, the polyester fiber is used not only the fibers or the clothes, they can use in the preparation of this plastics. And coming to the arrangement of monomers, due to the arrangement of monomers, we have the two types of plastics. If the monomers are arranged side by side, monomer side by side like this, then such type of plastics will call it as thermoplastics. And that when the monomers are joined like a long chain, linear chain, such type of plastics will call it as thermoplastics. Due to arrangement of these linear arrangement, these plastics are not strong. Means when you burn it, the links will melt it. Means the arranged monomers are linked, na? So that links will break it. Due to that, this plastics is not strong. Means when you heat it, easily melt it. Easily there, that plastic items will melt. And this plastic, thermoplastic items are used in the preparation of the toys, plates, cups, use and throw items. And this plastic, this thermoplastic, when you heat it, easily it changes into the liquid. When you cool it, it changes into the glassy state. Due to that, these items are used in the preparation of many several plastic items in our daily life. Next, coming to the other type of plastic, that is thermosetting plastic. In this thermosetting plastic, the arrangement of monomers are cross-linked. The arrangement of monomers are already I explained all this. Once again, I'm repeating these points. So due to the cross-linked arrangement, that plastic is very strong. When you heat it, that plastic items will not melt. Once if you prepare this thermosetting plastic items, after remolding, if you try to heat it, these plastic items will not melt. When you heat it, they become char and gives the fumes like that. Means once if you prepare a thermosetting plastic item, that you cannot change into other items by melting. But in the thermoplastics, if you take a comb, plate or glass, that items, if you melt it, if you heat, that plastic items are melting. That melting liquid you can use for the preparation of other plastic item. But coming to the thermosetting plastics, it is not possible. Once if you mold it, you cannot be remolded by heating this thermosetting plastics. And due to the cross-linked arrangement, these thermoplastic items are very, very strong. And these items are used as a bad conductor of heat and electricity. These thermosetting plastics, what are the examples of these thermosetting plastics? Backlight and melamine products. See, these backlit products are used in the switchboards and in the computer parts. And here ones, where switchboards, handles of utensils, landline phones. And these backlit products are used nowadays for the alternative of pearls and jades also. Now coming to the melamine products. Thermosetting plastics examples are two types, backlit and melamine. Now, these melamine products we can use in the preparation, sorry, kitchenware items, either cups set or otherwise dinnerware sets like that. And the floor and dress materials for the preparation, floors and the dress materials also, these melamine products are used. And for the computer, what is this, keyboard is used for the preparation of the computer keyboard is used by the melamine product plastics, and the TV cabinets, etc., for the preparation of those items, they are using these melamine products. Understand, children? In exam, they may ask, write the differences between thermoplastic and thermosetting plastics. Now, one more point is, we discussed about the lab activity. You have to collect different types of plastic items, pieces you collect. Some are thermoplastic and some are thermosetting plastics. So you collect the pieces and you burn it. When you burn it, if it melts, it comes under thermoplastic. If it does not burn, melt and gives and it becomes char, then it comes under thermosetting plastics. So that we have one lab activity 3. Next, by this you can identify whether the given plastic item is a thermoplastic or thermosetting plastic. Now, 10th point, why do we prefer plastics? We have so many items, metal items, wooden items, so many items. In all this, why we prefer nowadays, whatever the item you see, we can get all in plastics only. Why? Earlier days, people used golden plates for lunch, for food purpose. After that, silver. After that, metals. Then after that, nowadays, we are using this plastic plates. Why? Why we have to prefer plastics? Because plastics has more properties. They are lightweight, cheaper, and they are durable. They are durable. And these plastic items... lightweight also, it is easy to carry, it is easy to carry, and they are very cheaper. These plastic items are very cheaper, and like metal items, these plastic items will not corrode easily, will not corrode easily. And these plastic items you can make into the required shapes, whatever the desirable shapes you want, that you can get it, different shapes and sizes. And these plastic items are the poor conductors of heat and electricity. Due to that, for the handles of the cooker and switchboards and all these, we are using plastics. And for wiring purpose, we are prefer plastic items instead of metals and all. Next, plastics and environment. In our environment, plastic is a part. Without plastic, you can't imagine. So, okay, you are buying the plastic items and you are using. Suppose, if you go to the shop, you will get 4 or 5 plastic covers or plastic cups used and throw that. So, after uses of that items, what you are doing, you are throwing in the dustbins, or otherwise leftover food you are keeping in that covers and throwing into the nalas or the roadside. So, the leftover food, for that leftover food, the domestic animals like a cow, dog or something, that animals, they are eating that leftover food along with the cover. So, due to that, what happening, the plastic items are going into the stomachs of those animals, and this is very, very dangerous for the animals. Why? Because these plastic items are non-biodegradable items. First, we'll discuss about what are biodegradable and non-biodegradable. For example, you take some items, leftover food, leftover vegetables or bread and some plastic items. Like you collect some items and you observe that items In presence of sunlight, water and oxygen, these items, whatever you are collected, some of the objects, some of the leftover food and peels or something, these all in presence of sunlight, water and oxygen, they are changed or they convert into the small pieces. And again for small fragments, and again this for small fragments are once I will read and I will explain here. If you take certain materials, either food materials, they can break down into smaller fragments in presence of water, sunlight and oxygen. Again these fragments get further broken by bacteria. In presence of air, water and oxygen, they change into small pieces. Again these fragments are further broken by bacteria. This process is known as decomposition. We'll call it as decomposition. So very important, what is decomposition? So if I said you collect some items and you observe, and for the decomposition of each item, how many days it takes? Some of the object it takes either days or months or years. But if you take the plastic items, for the decomposition of this plastic item, it takes several years, maybe thousands or more than thousands of years. So that's why we should not use plastic items. Now, one more important short answer. Write about what is decomposition. That is one more question. Or otherwise, what is biodegradable and non-biodegradable. Biodegradable means the substances which are broken into the small pieces in presence of air, water and oxygen. Again these pieces or fragments are further broken by the bacteria. This process we'll call it as decomposition. So the items, whatever the substances are decomposed easily, are known as biodegradable. The substances which will not decompose, that we'll call it as non-biodegradable substances. So leftover food, peels, vegetables, all these are papers, wood, all the clothes, these are all comes under biodegradable substances. But plastics, it takes several years and they comes under the non-biodegradable substances. Nowadays we are using indiscriminately plastic items. So when there is a birthday party, using plastic cup, bottle, water bottle, spoons, glasses and all. After that, just simply you are throwing in that. Usage is very easy. But for the decomposition of that plastic, it takes years, thousands of years. So it is polluting our environment. So how to save our environment? For that, we have to follow 4R principle. And one more is that to avoid this polluting of our environment, you can burn the plastic. But when you burn the plastic items, harmful gases are releasing from the plastic item, and these gases also polluting the environment in our surrounding. So it is very, very dangerous. We should not burn the plastic items. So then how to minimize the uses of this plastic item? For that, we cannot stop uses of plastic because we are habituated. Then how to reduce, how to minimize the uses of these plastic items? For that, we have to follow 4R principle. What is 4R principle? What is 4R principle? Reuse, recycle and what is that? Once I will show you. Reduce, recycle and one more is reuse and recover. Here in last see I explained about the decomposition. I said now for that I wrote here on the paper. Once you see here, you collect the peel of fruits and vegetables. So for the decomposition it takes 1 to 2 weeks, and if it decomposes it is a degradable substance. Leftover food also it takes 1 to 2 weeks, so it is a degradable. And waste paper also it takes 10 to 30 days, so it is a degradable. And a cotton cloth it takes 2 to 5 months, so it comes under biodegradable substance. Plastic bags it takes several years, maybe more than 1000 years, so that's why this plastic items comes under non-biodegradable substances. So due to that we have to follow, to minimize the uses of plastics, we have to follow the 4R principle. So in that 4R principle, the first one is reduce the uses of plastic. Here I will write, what is 4R principle? The first one is reduce, and the second one is recycle, and the third one is reuse, and the fourth one is recover. If you follow the 4R principle, you can minimize the uses of the plastics. The first one, reduce. Now I said, we discussed, suppose if there was any marriage function or a birthday party or any function, first we are giving importance for the plastic items, plastic cups, plates, bottles, just use and throw in the dustbin. Due to that, the plastic items are accumulating. So first, stop the uses of such one-time uses of plastic items. Instead of that, you use the metal items, metal chairs, metal plates, like that you use. So you first, you try to avoid the uses of plastics. Okay, next, coming to the recycle. We'll discuss later this recycle. I will discuss about reuse. After reuse means the plastic item, suppose you have your school bag, so if you don't like that bag to use next year, so you don't throw that bag into dustbin or somewhere, you give to the poor people and you try to reuse it. What are the items you don't like, and don't throw that items in the dustbins or in the garbage. That you give to the poor people or the orphans, they can reuse it. They can reuse it. Like that, you can reuse that items. Means you give to some other persons. Next, coming to the, or otherwise, you when if you go to the market, you will get the carry bags. Simply don't throw in the dustbins. That you use several times. After that, you throw in the dustbin. Like that you use several times, reuse the items. Next, recycle. We have the codes, 1 to 6 codes and 7 codes. So each plastic item that you collect it and send it to the recycling centers. In that recycling centers, they are reusing these plastic items. Mainly code 1 and code 4, they are used for the recycling process. The remaining codes are very difficult for the recycling, and it is very difficult for the recycling also. What is that? Actually, for the recycling process, they will collect the items according to the code wise. So that lot they sent for the recycling. In that lot, if by mistake, if any code is mixed in that, suppose code 1 is used for the recycling. So in that recycling code 1, if by mistake any code 3 or code 4 or code 5 substance is mixed, the total lot is waste. for the recycling. So it is very, very important for the recycling. So the total lot is waste for the recycling. So while the recycling, it is very difficult, and they should see the symbols. According to that, they will send for the recycling. Okay, children. Next coming to the recover. Actually, we have to use this plastic item, waste management from the municipalities and all. The principle of recover plays a major role in solid waste management in municipalities. So you have to recover it. So by using this reduce, recycle, reuse and recover, if you follow this 4R principle, we can avoid the indiscriminate uses of plastic and we can save our environment. And you have one more question. Draw the universal recycling symbol. We have the triangles 1, 2 like that, and we have the universal recycling symbol. Like this, you have like this. I will show you from the textbook. This universal recycling symbol, this diagram is very important for short answers. Actually, when the number is omitted, so if you buy any plastic item, they may mention either 1, 2, 3 or numbers. Suppose if that number is omitted, if it is not given, then they may give that plastic items we should consider as a universal recycling symbol. So understand, children? Thank you. I completed lesson 3.